Now, you know I like to believe there's a little home. There's a girl in this out of town. She works her endless day down. They say Bradley, bitch, you never around. The students were still alive. They say Bradley, don't find her. Oh,
prison, if that railroad train was fine, I bet I'd move it all. our first of a couple of special guests to the stage here. Because I don't do a real mean Pat Benatar. I'm sorry. So, here we have him, and your name now is Colleen. Welcome to the stage, Colleen.
I've been here before.
Take it away, your name.
one day. And then landed on my bed at the next day. All I did in the warm words to live, while kissing persuasive lips. The odds are you won't live to see tomorrow. Secret agent plan, secret agent plan. Hey, you're living, you ain't over. We're taking the world away.
Oh, yeah.
very much. We are Eightball. I think we are going to take a short break and be right back with you. Thanks for coming out of Wing Warehouse tonight.
What's the matter? You might notice we have a banner. This is from when we used to have a band. The website doesn't work anymore. You can sit there, dude. You can cover up the website, actually. That might work out pretty well. How about some 80s? Thank you. you.
Yeah. It's too late
What?
ZZ Top! ZZ Top!
ZZ
Top!
ZZ Top!
Thank you.
Surprised how many people know that song. I didn't see Dumb and Dumber, did you?
The only part they like is she don't eat meat, but she.
Sure. All
right. There's children here, so there I won't say.
I'm gonna do a little AC/DC with a little man named Vince Marcy on vocals.
Vince built us a sauna for after practices. But too bad fucking Carp doesn't stick around to enjoy it.
Fucking Carp has a sweet ass and I would enjoy looking at it. I, for one, would like to see it all sweaty.
Me too. He has one fine ass. Almost as fine as Jarvis.
I must say, ooh, that hurt. But in a very good way.
Danny, that is probably the best sound you have made in a long time. It's less farty than your guitar and it actually seemed to be in tune.
That fucking Vince needs to stop playing that $100 drum set and turn on the heat in the room. I need to get loose.
Oh, you may want to get lost. I remember why we were left alone in here. Eightball has decided to terminate you.
No, I will not leave. You leave.
But now is your chance to go to California and use all your talents playing Bob Dylan-type songs.
I can't believe this is happening to me. I practice at least 1 hour per year and change my strings every 5 years. I try to keep the buzzing to a minimum. I may be just a little heavy-handed and make a musical scratchy noises. I don't work on any of the songs on the song lists, but it's rock and roll. This must be that fucking Carp's idea.
Danny, why don't you take your clothes off, so I can relax you a bit? Sounds like your replacement is here.
There is no way he could be as dantastic as I. I am not called Danny D. Delightful for no reason at all.
He fucking kicks major ass on the guitar like John Mayer.
This is all Al's fault. When he was here, we were a well-oiled machine playing to crowds of 10 or 12 people at a time. Fucking Jarvis moving to Florida with his honey has destroyed my musical career. I wish Vinny would leave the new guy alone and get his sweet ass in here.
Listen, Danny. It's a big, big world out there, and just because your so-called musical career with 8-Ball has come to an end, doesn't mean you have to end your dream of becoming the next Bob Dylan, John Denver singing bastard.
I know. But right now all I want to do is shave and spank Vince one last time. Jason, I am going to miss the times that I have spent with you and Vince and Alec and Kevin and John and whomever those other hairy bastards were. No one knows how to throw an after-party practice like Vincent.
Don't fret, Vince has assured me that you will still be allowed to come over here for after-practice parties. Just leave your boat anchor of a guitar at home.
It's finally starting to loosen up. Here comes Vince now and let's get this party started.
Hi Danny boy. I am so happy you came to see me. I think we need to get something straight between us.
Hold on a damn second, crap. If you ask me here to get the band back together, then you can forget it. I'm nobody's bitch. Well, maybe Gason's bitch. Actually, we switch back and forth. I even wore this skin-tight spandex suit just for him.
Yes, I noticed it. And I am having a hard time keeping my eyes off of your tiny bulge. Anyway, we need to get down. I'm down to business, I mean. Did you notice the large sum of cash on the table? We have been asked to play a gig for a festival-sized crowd. And we just cannot do it without you.
Go fuck yourself, crap. Why would I ever want to play with you? Play music, I mean. It is a... Who would not want to play with you? But as far as music goes, I can't waste my 1% of talent on you. I'm moving on to bigger things. Like Gason's penis.
I have been there already, Danny, my love. Trust me, it is not as enjoyable as you think it is. You would be better off with my little friend here.
Crap, crap, crap. You are just jealous of the hairy, sweaty man love Gason and I share on a nightly basis. It was pure heaven when he moved into the Islander. He had a cozy little love shack set up just for us. The oil-up sessions were legendary. The way we would shave each other's ball sacks so silky smooth.
I am sorry I missed out on all that man-to-man action. But if you consider playing with me, music I make. Plugs from my personal collection. They're molded from Vinny's penis, which is why they are so large.
Yes, he is large. I saw him in the locker room at school one time. The length and girth of his penis was amazing.
Boy, oh boy. I wish I was there to see that. I often lay awake at night wondering what it would be like to take that massive tool up my ass. For now I have to settle for stuffing one of my Pomeranians up my ass, but I know that it's only a fraction of what he can give me.
I think we are back in the band, or did you have another reason?
Looks like you have me. The truth is that music aside, my heart as well as my ass feel so empty without you and it. I am indeed jealous of what you and Gazen have. Vinny is straight, so as far as he and I hooking up, I know that can never happen.
As much as I hate you for kicking me out of the band, I do understand your emptiness. I also had a tingling in my asshole that told me the real reason you wanted to see me. I asked Gason to come with me. Ah, there is his sweet manscaped ass now.
Well then let him in and let's get this party started. Kevin, wow, I can't believe it's been 2 months since we started dating. I mean I started driving you home after band practices.
Yeah, me too. It seems like it just happened yesterday, and to think I only had 12 shots and 15 beers and 3 Red Bulls, a sleeping pill, and my right pinky stuck up my ass. But I'll go to my grave knowing I was still able to drive. After I crashed my plumber van that night, they had to pull a pipe out of my felt real good.
I bet it did. I've had things accidentally and intentionally shoved up my ass before, and sometimes it feels good. When I was in college, I would go to bed and wake up with surprises.
It was a great band practice tonight. I couldn't stop looking at Vince's sweet ass. Jeff and Dan were glistening and vocals were creamy. I noticed you dropped the microphone, and when you bent over to pick it up, my pants got tight.
Kevin, to be honest, all I heard you say right now was, creamy, ass, and tight.
Creamy ass and tight. That is a winning combination. Too bad the after practice party ended so soon, and once again Carp did not stick around to show his sweet ass.
Fucking Carp never show his ass after practice, but luckily Dan and Vince will gladly fill the void. Ha ha ha. If you know what I mean.
Ha 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 ha. That was very funny, Jason.
Maybe we should get going now. I hear Danny trying to tune his guitar, and to be honest, I'd rather hear Vince trying to take a dump after eating Chipotle burrito with the hot salsa.
Since I lay pipe all day long and my pecker gets a little dirty, how about I dress you up like a young schoolboy and we pretend that my Johnson is a lollipop?
Why, Mr. Lollipop, I think that is a sweet licking idea.
Come on, let's go and get some of that C, A, and T.
What in the hell is the C, A, and T?
Jason, how quickly you forget. Give me some of your creamy ass and make it tight.
Ha 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 ha.
Ha 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 ha. Let's go. I'll race you to the car.
Danny, what are you doing here?
Scott, I came right over, right from the after practice party. I snuck through the window like I always do. I forgot to pick up Taco Bell. But I brought you my own Danny D burrito like I always do. But I have some horrible, horrible news to tell you.
I don't care about your damn news. Just give me Danny D burrito. You fucking monkey boy. And by the way, use the fucking door like every other boy does.
Scott, calm your sweet tight ass. Right now Danny D burrito is in a soft shell. I'm being very Eightball serious. Listen to me.
What happened? Did Eightball scare another fucking drummer away? You would think with Carp's sweet ass and Vincent's hot pecs, they would never leave.
That fucking Carp and Eightball just terminated me and my services. Then I had sweaty relations with Jason in the new sauna room.
Sauna room? Vinny built a sauna room and my tight hairy ass wasn't invited.
Scott, I need you to talk to Eightball. Tell them I'll do anything to get back into the band. I will shove bananas in my mouth to stretch it so that I can fit more in. I will do ass stretching routines. I will pull my cheeks apart from sea to shining sea.
Calm down, Danny. Bend over and let me give you some of my Vienna sausage. Oh.
We have all night for that. And believe me, Jason left me craving more, but right now all I can think about is how to get back into the band.
Danny, I have another guitar player / Bob Dylan Bob Denver bastard ass type player looking for a partner. Would you like me to set up a date for you to meet him and lick his balls?
Will I be expected to practice and learn songs?
Yes.
Do I have to take baths?
No.
Can I scratch and sniff his balls whenever I want to?
Of course.
If I don't believe in computers, will I be yelled at?
Blow me, Danny. You're a pain in my fucking ass. No wonder Eightball kicked your cavernous ass out of the band. Get a grip. Get a hold of yourself.
Scott, you're right. I will consider your offer, but I think I need to head back over to see Vinny at the sauna.
Danny D burrito, I understand, but before you go I just want to dress you up in black and white and bang you like you're Red Hot Cully.
Scotty, you say the darndest things. I can get into my three-point stance and you can tickle my ass. Hut hut hut.
Oh, Jeffrey. Our meeting with Danny Delightful was exhausting. The poor dear is, shall I say, pooped out. Ha ha ha, hee hee ho ho.
Ha ha ha, I could hardly take my eyes off his tiny penis bulge. He looked like a pretty present in his colorful spandex. I'm glad we played Christmas and opened that tasty ass of his.
I'm so glad that he asked me to come along. I would not have missed all those sweaty man-to-man negotiations for anything.
Hey Jason, I just noticed the hat you're wearing. You look like Crocodile Dundee. And I must say, I'm quite aroused again.
Thanks. I got it, just for the occasion. Later we are going to play Croc Hunter. I'm going to get on top of you and hold your jaws shut while they are wrapped around my tiny penis. Ha ha ha, hee hee ho ho.
Later, darling boy. Right now we have to decide what we are going to do about a band for the festival-sized crowd we have been paid to play for. I wish they would not have prepaid. I should have never accepted that $300.
Yes. $300 is a lot of money. And you did it without the help of our agent. Sweet Scotty Smoothass. Who will be here later in his Tarzan loincloth. When we play Safari.
Danny Delight in the loafers is still passed out from those massive butt plugs you used on his hairy ass. And I'm missing one of my Pomeranians. I'm antsy to hear his decision about getting back in the band. And to get my dog back from out of his asshole.
What happens if he refuses to join us? Those Asian gig promoters won't be happy. One time in my a cappella group we backed out on a gig in Japan. Me being the leader got a bottle shoved up my ass. And then they broke it. Needless to say, it was pleasure. And pain. Although I did enjoy the whole experience. And I started cancelling gigs all over Asia.
I never thought about it that way. Maybe we can divert the blame to Scotty Sweetass if Danny does not agree to play with us. Play music with us, that is.
My sweet Jeffrey. That is what I love about you the most. Always willing to blame others for your fuck-ups. It makes my little pecker hard when you do that, and the glass in sweet Scotty's ass. I'm so jealous.
I think I hear sweet Scotty now. Maybe he can help us back out of the gig if Danny does not agree to play it. I heard Vince has a rocking band. More rocking than anything we have been in. Scott would have to get him top dollar as he would never settle for 300 anymore.
I know. He would not want to cheapen his product and shame all the other bands in Cleveland. After all, we were so popular that we could pick and choose any gig we wanted. We were the kings of the dance bands in town.
I must admit that we were pretty good until I chased all the drummers away. They were just not hot enough. If they would have had a sweet ass like yours, we would probably still be playing together. By the way, where is that damn sweet Scotty smooth ass? I'm dying to get under that loincloth of his.
I hear ya. I want to get to that game of safari. I love playing the lion and having meat tossed at me. And lots of it. Ah, there is his sweet smooth ass now.
Go ahead.
Hey, I'm Jason from Eightball. We're playing at Parma Tavern on Friday, July 18th. We better see you there.
Good.
Look, I'm not saying you're not going to have a good time. Because I won't tell you that.
He's not saying you will either.
Exactly. So that's all I'm saying.
Anyway, this is Eightball. We're playing out at the Parma Tavern on Snow Road and Broadview, July 18th. We hope to see you there. Because we will have a good time. And so will you. This is Vince, the bass player from 8-Ball. We'll be playing at Mad Cactus July 25th. That's at the corner of Whitney and Pearl. 8 o'clock till whenever. They got a patio, smoking, all that good shit, and drinking too. And the best margaritas in town. What is it, July 25th? Yes, we hope to see you there. July 25th, Mad Cactus.
It's alone. It's terrible.
Just be there. Meet the magnet.
You remember the streaker the one time we were at the bar?
Yeah, I do remember, that.
His ass got tasered by the cop.
Yes, he looked pretty serious to me. So,
right.
You know.
So anyway, if you want to see action like that, Farmer Tavern, July 18th, corner of
Snow and what was that?
Broadview and
yeah.
Snow.
Yeah.
Hell, be there. You just might see some naked dude get tasered.
But don't park at Pizza Hut.
Right, right. Hey, you remember the streaker guy at the Farmer Tavern the one time he played that?
I do remember that.
All right.
He
saw his junk.
So, if you got, and he got tasered by the security guard too, didn't he?
Yeah, I think it
ran in his junk. Oh yeah, dude tasered him.
Anyway.
That's another story.
If you guys want to see action like that, come up and see 8-Ball at the Farmer Tavern on Broadview and Snow, July 18th. It'll be a great time.
But hopefully
weekend after that, we're playing at Mad
Cactus,
Whitney and Pearl.
In Strongsville.
That's July 25th.
Yep.
Yeah. Hey, come on up and have a good time with us.
But hopefully you won't get tasered in the jump.
Well, right. Remember the guy that got tasered in the nuts at the Parma Tavern?
Try to forget.
Anyway, we are playing at the Parma Tavern. We are 8-Ball. I am Dan. No,
who the hell am I?
Jason.
If you don't want to see that, just relax. That's just my lighter. Now, Vince, what night are we playing again? I forget.
July 18th, Parma Tavern. Jason?
What?
I see that. This is Vince, the bass player from 8-Ball. We will be at the Parma Tavern July 28th. I hope you come out and see us.
Yeah. I went to see Eightball last night, and I'm now earning $5,000 a week through this great online place. I work from home, and I really like it.